The U.S. Poker Open is now in full swing. Coming to you from Las Vegas, Nevada, welcome to the PokerGO studio. Come on inside, everyone, as we bring you in to the break desk at the 2021 USPO. He is Brent Hanks. I am Jeff Platt. Thank you all so much for being here. And Brent, there's a real buzz around this studio. We are back in a groove, it seems.
Oh, we're certainly in a groove. I don't know if it's a buzz, Jeff. Whatever sound an eagle makes, a caca, that's the noise
caca.
I hear in here.
The caca is good. Yeah. I like the caca. Let's take a look at our series summary brought to you by PokerCoaching.com. 12 events over these next 13 days and an added $50,000 and the Golden Eagle Trophy to the winner of the U.S. Poker Open. Jake Daniels, the winner of event number one. Sam Soverell, the winner of event number two, the 10K PLO. But who will win event number three, Mr. Hanks? An absolutely stacked final table today. Taking a look at our leaderboard brought to you by Global Poker, free poker at its best. The 2015 main event champ, Joe McKeehen, leads the way. PokerGO Tour leader, Ali Imsirovic, is right there. Brent, what stands out to you? Besides Zolotow, we'll get to him later.
Of course, you know I want to talk about the bald eagle, Stevie Z, but Jeff, you and I are always talking about Ali Imsirovic,
yeah,
the Bosnian bandit. He's going to win this. He's winning that. He's on top of the PokerGO Tour leaderboard. Joe McKeehen is the guy that stands out to me. Joe McKeehen,
ooh,
might be the most underrated player that we never talk about. He's won the main event. He crushes high rollers at a consistent clip. He plays some of the smaller events. He's a man of the people, Jeff, and he showed up at our studio this morning so we could watch his beloved 76ers at the crack of dawn.
He is the chip leader in this one, in event number three. All right, Brent, let's talk fantasy poker. If you want to play daily fantasy poker, you can get in the mix on Super Draft. And hey, we're both in the money right now, yeah?
Oh, baby, look at us, huh? We're in the money.
And yeah, so we're in the money, so, you know, I could win, you could win, that kind of thing?
I don't think you can beat me, Jeff. Take a look at what we've got right here, huh?
The side-by-side, comparison of our scores. Is this going to be an ugly one for me?
No.
Oh, I just can't beat you, though.
We're close, all right? I am Team White Magic, of course.
Of course.
And you are team, well, Jeff Platt, very creative.
Thank you.
With that one. We
Thank
both
you.
Share Ali Imsirovic. I got you with Sergio Ido. There's my multiplier bonus up there in the champion spot. And Negrano, we share him as well. He snuck in a little 25-point, 11th through 15th finish.
All right, make sure to fire Daily Fantasy Poker, available to you on Superdraft. All right, Brent, one of the top storylines in this series. How about the reemergence of one Steve Zolotow? Fifth place finish in event number one, and he's back at the final table in event number three.
Inspired by the Golden Eagle trophy, the bald eagle has landed, ladies and gentlemen. He goes back-to-back in the no-limit events. He's trying to take this thing down. How do you not love Stevie Z in that mustache?
And with a second place finish or better, Zolotow will move into first place in the series unless Barry Hutter beats him heads up. Also the second final table of the series for Hutter. So McKeehen and Imsirovic lead the way at event number three, the 10K No Limit final table. Our coverage of that final table starts right now. Las Vegas, Nevada, the home for one of the most prestigious high roller series in the game. This is the U.S. Poker Open. Welcome to the PokerGO studio. It is final table coverage of event number three, a 10K No Limit Hold'em tournament featuring the best of the best. Jeff Platt alongside Brent Hanks in the broadcast booth. And Brent, today, our Golden Eagle Trophy will get a pretty good view of a pretty stacked final table.
Oh, stacked, you can say that again, Jeff. How about Joe McKeehen,
woo,
with the chip lead, former WSOP main event champion, looking to take home that beautiful bird right there.
Our leaderboard brought to you by Global Poker, free poker at its best. There is McKeehen at the top, Ali Imsirovic right there, Steve Zolotow, Ray Qartomy, Justin Saliba, Jake Schindler, and Barry Hutter do indeed round out our final table. They are all looking up at that man right there, Joe
McKeehen. You said it. He's the 2015 World Series of Poker Main Event champ. More than $17 million in career live tournament earnings.
He's unbelievable, Jeff. We talked about it at the top of the show. His results in the high rollers speak for themselves.
Look who it is, Brent. Sorry to cut you off, but look who it is.
Oh, Stevie Z, the man with the mustache heard round the world. Look at this guy, huh? The bald eagle, the nickname. He's inspired. He's poised.
Speaking of inspired, this man's been here before. Ali Imsirovic, the 2018 Poker Masters champion, the PokerGO tour leader, and just an absolute crusher.
Yeah, the Bosnian bandit. No surprise, Jeff, once again shows up here with a pile of chips. Looking at these payouts, he wants number one.
Our final seven guaranteed $38,500, about an 8K pay jump from seventh to sixth. And up top in this one, more than $200,000 and 200 points in the race for that U.S. Poker Open Series championship. Hutter, Saliba, McKeehen, Qartomy, Zolotow, Imsirovic, and Schindler, your final table, 30K, 60K blinds with a 60K big blind ante.
There's the Hutter butter. He final tabled event number one alongside table mate Steve Zolotow. And Jake Schindler, I don't know if you saw this, Jeff, he's still wearing his slippers.
I missed that. He'll raise it up with the ace, deuce of diamonds. Schindler starting things off as one of the short stacks with about 15 bigs. McKeehen, the king 10 of spades in the small blind.
Getting an all right price. He's a little perplexed, not comfortable right now with Schindler, the snake opening up early position.
The enthusiastic Ray Qartomy.
Oh, yeah, the marble man.
Merry Christmas, Ray.
Mr. Qartomy, how about this? Okay. Always talking, laughing. He's going to put on a show today.
Oh, he loves it.
Nine.
10 seconds.
Nine. All right, I call.
Boom.
Qartomy told us prior to play he just had a feeling that he would win this tournament. See if he can start by beating Jake Schindler in a pot as it comes. Ace 10-6, perhaps some trouble for Schindler.
A lot of trouble. Let's see how Jake decides to navigate. Oftentimes you'll see a deceptive little check back, under-repped on the flop for the times we did get unlucky.
All the work I did last night was literally nothing. That was definitely
he's gonna go with the min bet here, Jeff. Control the pot. Lay a price for worse hands.
I got fucking jack in the box on the way home. That was
the question is, what do you do if you face any resistance out of Ray right now?
It will not happen again. Lesson learned.
Raise 120 total.
There is the resistance in the form of a check min raise.
And it's just weird right away. And Schindler, quick call.
You gotta have fast food chicken
nuggets. Certainly don't fault him for that.
Spicy nuggets too, but there's no Wendy's on the way home.
The turn is a nine, aces and nines for Ray Qartomy.
And I guess that's why Jake wore the slippers on his way back to the couch after this one.
I don't think I've had Burger King in years.
570K in the pot, as you see on the bottom right corner of your screen. Schindler with 690K behind. Player's current stack size is bottom left corner.
Ray here, no fear. Ray here, no fear. Let's do it, baby.
Look at that, Jeff. Just a snap fault by Schindler, correct.
Nice pickup for Ray Qartomy to pick things off.
My dealer.
Qartomy out of Spring, Texas. I love this guy already.
Yeah.
Ray Qartomy going to keep us entertained. Ali Imsirovic on top of our PokerGO Tour leaderboard. And Brent, 19 different players have won one PokerGO Tour event. Sean Perry and Sam Savarov have won two. Ali Imsirovic has won five. He's won five PokerGO Tour events in 2021.
Unbelievable. I don't know how Ali Imsirovic does it. I think it's the lucky hoodie that he wears at all these final tables.
Why?
What is that show again, Jeff?
Dragon Ball Z?
Dragon Ball Z. There it is.
Real decision was real, man.
Starting to build his oh-so-familiar mountain.
What we got to do is play fast. All the people watching us that look up to us also play fast and don't become dicks like everyone else is and just obnoxious.
You shouldn't tank 15 seconds then.
Yeah, but I had a real decision. I had a real decision with real money on the line. I don't do that shit in level one, man.
Schindler now with ace queen. Under 12 bigs now.
I mean, it's a bad thing.
Puts plenty of it in the middle.
There's sort of a premium for stealing when, for stalling when there are a lot of tables left.
Yeah, it's awful. It is what it is, though. Can't, there's no better fix than what we have right now.
They're talking about stalling. Ray took a little time there with the old Doyle. Jeff, you know, you can't let it go too fast.
Ace Jack.
You're taking your revenge out on me because you lost the pot to him.
For Zolotow.
300.
This is close for Stevie Z. He knows it. Look at him. Wait, I've got Ace Jack. This guy's got a little bit more than 10 bigs.
I don't know why I'm going to let you have it.
And does fold the Ace Jack.
Probably I'm going to hate myself when I see the replay.
No, you're going to love it.
Probably not.
As Jake says, probably not.
Correct fold again by the wise one. The bald eagle. Dr. Denham.
This is Jake Schindler's seventh career USPO cash. He has three second-place finishes at the U.S. Poker Open.
That's like out of the zone of the ones I normally look at.
So that's where we can get you, huh?
Yeah. Up to double the pot, I sort of know. But four times.
Oh, wow.
Not just the King of Spades, but the King of Clubs here for Barry Hutter. Starting the hand with about 12 bigs.
120,000.
Raises it up to 120K.
Probably the MDF is like 20%.
So like 720,
right?
720. Ali Imsirovic looks down at the 7-5 in the big blind.
And you're going to see this quite a bit, Jeff. I don't know if Ali will defend here. Curious about Hutter's raise off of that small stack size. Mm.
Looks suspicious, perhaps,
Yeah, Ali. You know, the thing is, though, we saw this in event one with Barry when he got short, as well as other players. They're still raising to the min when they have between 10 and 15 bigs in their stack. Why? Keep a few bluffs involved, as well as their premiums.
Hutter cashed for $114,000 in event number one after a third-place finish.
Like eight, right?
More than $6.3 million in career tournament earnings as you take a look at his bio, brought to you by GPI and the Hand'em Up.
I'll tell you what, Hutter looks good physically. He's clearly been working out quite a bit. I saw him before this final table started. I know he's been playing a lot of golf out there. I think he's been hitting the gym. Typically, the old physical health goes quite well with the mental health. That could explain why he's got two final tables.
He's got Ace Jack here. Lays it down. Average stack at this point, a little more than 20 bigs. Joe McKeehen, the chip leader, with the queen jack of clubs.
Raise, 120 total.
Come in for a raise. Those blue chips worth 5,000, purple chips 25K apiece, yellow bumblebees worth 100K apiece.
Look at McKeehen, just Ray up and down. Joe loves to look his opponents directly in the eye, watches all the motions.
No fear, I'm out.
Got it, baby boy.
Lots of fear, I'm out.
You got it.
Heads up, McKeehen and Qartomy.
You want a day about here?
Huh?
You want a day about here?
Say that again?
Said you want to go nuts here?
6-5 deuce rainbow.
Not really.
Qartomy with the overpair.
Not a club on the board, not a single Broadway ticket. I have to imagine McKeehen is concerned about Qartomy, and undeterred, he's going to come after it right now. Fires a C-bet, rather healthy, 130.
After I bet, I looked at him, I'm like, oh, I'm losing.
Designed to fold out better.
You hear Schindler tell Ali, perhaps had a tell on Qartomy in the first hand. Said, I looked at him and thought, oh no, I'm losing. Qartomy's eighth still good here.
What's wrong?
Nah, you're right. Kind of. I like one too. I was never actually into it.
Yes, no, that's what I thought.
I can't imagine McKeehen would go any further in this hand.
Maybe.
He's hoping that continuation bet with a folded out of hand like king, queen, ace, jack, and look at this.
Yeah, here he comes.
He's going for it. Two streets. A non-believer. Gives Qartomy credit for being able to float without much. Obviously, we can see that he's wrong. Pocket eights aren't going anywhere, Jeff.
You see that clip from the PO tournament? There's this guy who forgot he was mic'd up. Like, he gets a, he has a flush, he's into a boat, and he won. And he's walking around
Jimmy
over there.
Makes the call.
He's like, good looking worry, and he's like, get crushed, he's motherfuckers. It's so funny, bro. I'll find it. I'll show it to you later. It's so good, dude.
But he was out of the tournament, you see?
Yeah, he thought he won. Yeah,
will right. McKeehen empty the clip
and he was like,
or wave the white flag?
1.2 million in the pot.
Oh, my goodness.
McKeehen going for it, firing flop, firing turn, all of it on the river. Can Qartomy find the call with the eights?
10 seconds.
If he does, he's our new chip leader.
I've just been like, I'm here. It has almost everything I need.
Wait, not at all yet.
Uses that time extension, granting him an additional 30 seconds to act.
I don't care what happens. This is absolutely heroic by Joe McKeehen. Sets the tone early at this final table.
If I got busier, I'd probably stop going just because it's small.
Yeah, I agree.
10 seconds.
What have you been doing?
I walked on the treadmill last time when I got home. Because I, like, ate a big ass burger.
Wow. Lays it down. McKeehen gets it done with just queen high.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is why he is the world champion, Joe McKeehen. Hello.
Whew. The winner of the main in 2015. Look at his bio, brought to you by GPI and the Hendon Mob. Graduated from Arcadia University with a degree in math. McKeehen out of Pennsylvania, second in the state's all-time money list to one Jake Schindler.
What a start.
The Eagle approves of that one.
Holy cow, I am pretty floored right away. I did not expect that hand to unravel. Like that. Good Lord.
I had at least four to a straight.
That is true. He did river an open-ended straight draw.
Which means I have a three, a four, a seven, an eight. King jack, king queen.
Race 125.
Here he comes, Jeff. Stevie Z.
Opening in the cutoff to 125K. Schindler in the small blind started the hand with 12 bigs. As king queen, it all goes in.
Can we get a count? Six.
I think it's 720.
720, yeah.
Says no thanks. Nice pickup for Schindler. He, Hutter, and Qartomy, the short stacks,
it's two. The third
under
one
15
bits.
Called,
you better really have it. That
one. Ooh, I like that trash.
What?
And now he's going to have it, and I'm going to call. I can see it's a bad sign. I should
what?
Never have told
you
him.
You call the show?
Thanks so much.
No problem.
Yeah.
You saved me $200,000.
Yeah, you're welcome for that. I almost voted. I was like, you know, he's probably asking to mind.
Yeah, but like, you could have also just won.
Jake the Snake, I know Daniel Negreanu believes that Schindler might be the best player as far as these high roller tournaments are concerned. This man, though, McKeehen, he's putting on a clinic right away.
Queen Jack here.
Let's see what he does with Queen Jack this time.
Raise 120.
feels personal, doesn't it, Jeff? Between Ray and Joe right now?
It started to after McKeehen was implying that he certainly didn't have it.
Right. Here we go. Speaking of having it, though.
Yeah.
360.
Raise
the
360.
Off a 20 big blind stack, three bets, not all in. Makes it 360K. Hutter quickly folds the eights.
Don't bother.
Damn, Jake got you mad.
Well, I'm learning from him.
You're taking it out on me because Jake got you.
I know Jake is a great player. I have to learn from him, you know.
A lot can be learned from the career of Steve Zolotow.
Nothing to do with it.
Yeah, I bet.
Two-time World Series of Poker bracelet winner.
I hope I get an A7 off there.
Yeah, I want to feel him.
Eagle and eagle.
You found my bottom.
Oh, boy. Eagle squared.
Look at that Golden Eagle trophy. It weighs 54 pounds, 23 inches tall.
Damn, is that bad?
No, it's bigger than Lombardi.
Oh, it's massive. And how about the Eagle Eye Cherry on top? The 50K bonus going to the USPO champion, Jeff.
It's quite nice.
Did you catch the reference there, by the way?
If one was a king,
Eagle Eye Cherry? No.
I didn't have a king.
I still don't get it.
No.
Eagle Eye Cherry.
I'm surprised. Your music taste, I thought you'd be all over that one.
The only guy I don't
What are you going to explain it or just let me think about
band,
it for a
Jeff,
while?
A song, yeah, a lot like Celine.
So okay. So, but it's not a Celine song.
Absolute shit out.
Well, maybe she covered it.
Kind of opening
perhaps. Schindler raises it up with the A7 of hearts.
I guess I got to look now.
Game with Jack 9 in the big blind. Old defense. Will flop a 9, unfortunately for him. Schindler flops aces and the ace high flush draw.
The whole world for the snake, Jake Schindler.
It's 80K.
I wouldn't expect McKeehen to fold middle pair quite yet. Getting a nice price, try and connect. Your 9 can, of course, still be good.
Does indeed check call. 8 of spades on the turn. Schindler now also with a gut shot.
Check.
Schindler stack size, 765 behind, nearly 500,000 in the middle. Folks at home tuning in, what do you do when you're in these spots? Take notes. 150 gets it done, Jeff.
Pretty quick fold by McKeehen. Another nice pickup for Jake Schindler. Almost $26 million in career tournament earnings. Seven cashes throughout his career at the U.S. Poker Open. Includes 3 second place finishes. Take a look at his bio, brought to you by GPI and the Hennemann. I think he looks at the PokerGO studio as his home court.
No, it's his home court, and it's also his backyard. He can quite literally roll out of bed, come down an elevator, head outside, and he's home. Not only are Imsirovic and Schindler neighbors here, but they're neighbors as well, located right next door to the studio. Talk a lot of poker.
It's been too many hands for Ali to sit out, so he has to raise it up here with the ace five.
McKeehen with a swig. Take a look at a little 7-4 suited. I don't think we're coming along for the ride.
How about Qartomy in the big blind with the queen eight of spades into the muck?
Boy, I think you got a peel there, yeah. Marble Man. Ray Qartomy from Houston, Texas. He owns a granite marble sort of stone countertop business, Jeff.
Yeah, Galaxy Stone.
Yeah.
How about that? Qartomy, close to $4 million in career life tournament earnings. As we take a look at our tournament format brought to you by PokerCoaching.com. 40-minute levels throughout this entire tournament. Starting stack was 125K. Could fire three bullets at this one, and each player received six 30-second time extensions. They'll get six more when we get down to six players left. Ace three suited this time.
120.
Imsirovic. 120. Qartomy with A7 off here in the small blind.
Looks interested, perhaps because Ali had opened the hand prior. He was considering going with the A7 here. A non-believer.
What do you think?
Not gonna cut it.
What's the other one though?
Ace three spades.
Okay. Four of hearts.
I mean, who the hell lies about that card? In that position.
I did have the blocker. I had the four.
I don't
of
think
spades.
The dealer heard me say all in though. So you can give me that pot. I bet you would have folded.
You're right.
2018 Purple Jacket winner, Ali Imsirovic.
You must really hate me if that's the case.
It's hard to
from
hate
Bosnia
you.
Originally.
Come on.
So it's just his second career U.S. Poker Open cash. He did win the 25K in 2019 for more than $440,000.
Thank you, Joe.
You're welcome.
That's definitely not true.
He loves the Purple Jacket.
Yeah, Steve for sure.
Maybe the Eagle. Changes too. He wants the title in this major as well.
I didn't mean to disrespect you.
What did you say about me?
You're a lovable person.
Yeah.
Lovable?
Yeah.
But Ali had to remind me. That's the
how come none of the cute girls ever tell me that?
Good question.
It's just bald-headed guys. That's all I get.
Ace King for Qartomy on the button. Starting the hand with 12 bigs.
Ray certainly does take his time, and he's trying to sell it right here, Jeff.
All in.
All in.
All of it.
Get him, Ray.
$750?
You know what it is?
Slightly less.
It's like seven, right?
Yes. Can't see what's around the corner here. Okay.
Fold, fold. Qartomy picks it up.
All right, we'll take the dance. Can't get a tier, we gotta get a dance.
And we like when Ray wins pots. He's gonna get a little bit more chatty.
Yeah,
keeps
yeah.
Keeps the table on their toes a little bit.
Out of Texas. He and his wife Nancy have five kids.
I had a believe, I still have a believe. I'm gonna win that tournament.
Still believes that he's going to win this one.
This one.
You said that one, so now you can't win this.
You're closer to winning the tournament since you won the pot.
This one.
You're closer to winning the tournament because you folded river against me, too.
It's all right. It's always Nick's hand.
I'm saying, you might have been beat.
It's always Nick's hand.
I see you're still on.
Told us he had a feeling, premonition, a belief, whatever you want to call it, that he was going to win this tournament. Got some work to do.
That when the 10K.
He had worse than 9-8.
I've never had that feeling in my entire career, Jeff. I sure as hell know the same is true for you.
I have 9-8.
I think you had worse than 9-8. You had like
I would never fold 9-8.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
10-8 of clubs. Pretty one for Schindler in the big blind.
For
Zolotow open on the button with king three of diamonds.
The truth. The camera was
still all in. Three
more minutes.
That's what I'm saying. You can see that. You don't have to tell me. I'm not.
Comes 5-3-3 with two clubs. Schindler flops the flush draw. Trip threes for Zolotow.
That's got to be 60.
Oh, sorry.
Trying to bet the men.
Trying to bet less than the men, Jeff.
Right.
He's got himself a monster. He sets the crab trap.
60,000.
I feel like you have to tell me first before I tell you.
Schindler's got a fun sort of hand. Two overs to the board in his mind with a club draw. And less than 20 bigs in his stack. Does he appreciate the price, or does he try and play for a little bit more? There it is, the raise.
That check raised to 250,000.
What's behind? Eight in the corner. All in.
All in.
Schindler.
Zolotow rips it
now. Not like this spot.
Yep. Quickly lays it down.
I warned you.
You did warn him.
It's true.
You did.
Yeah. You knew that showed a very good hand. I was representing weakness, you know. Yeah. The.
It's a little too tight, though. It's just a little. Yeah. I warned you.
You did.
I love it.
This might be the best viewer final table.
Might be, honestly. If Ray starts singing, for sure.
I told Ray, do a cheer when you folded the river, and he just did, or not the river, when you folded, when he went all in, you folded the big blind, and he just gave a little dance. It wasn't as good, but better than nothing.
Got some real entertainment value at this final table, I would say.
Yeah, now this side over here, Hutter and Saliba, we haven't heard anything from quite yet.
Quiet start for Justin Saliba, pretty card dead early. Has about 15 bigs, 16.
Sometimes you're just handcuffed by your stack and your seat position. So brutal having Joe McKeehen directly to your left.
We now have four stacks under the 1 million chip mark.
Raise.
Total.
Qartomy raising it up here. We know he has at least the ace of diamonds. And that'll work. We don't even need to see the other one.
That's it.
Wow, no song or anything?
No, that one was all business. I double up.
Better not let you double up there.
It's just maybe mini one.
You know you got twice his chips, Ali. I'll still take Ray over you.
Huh?
You know you got twice his chips, I'll still take Ray over you.
Me too.
I feel double up is coming. I feel double up is coming. It's gonna be a little dance.
I hope it comes from Joe.
From Joe?
I hope so.
Almost was gonna double up for me. Almost. It's okay, I let him pass one time. I let him pass one time. It's all right. Let him get excited next time.
Joe only gets excited about the 76ers.
Not today.
Not today, he says. The day of game one against the Hawks. Second round of the NBA playoffs.
Jeffy showed up more than 2 hours early here at the studio just to watch that
Planned
game.
It out well.
Right.
I don't think he was particularly thrilled with how that game progressed.
I'm still here. I'm still here, my friend.
Yes, you are.
Old pass, you get a cheap small blind. There we go.
Well, you convinced him. Well,
talked him into that one.
I wanted a cheap big blind. It's Saliba.
You wanted him to fold.
Oh, was 7-8 up. I thought he had 7-8 suited.
I couldn't call a shove, so anything, but that's fine. I also wanted a cheap small blind.
Good start to the day for Joe McKeehen. The three-time World Series of Poker bracelet winner won the main in 2015, the 10K limit in 2017.
You're not allowed to any blind.
The online high roller in 2020.
Ooh.
Okay. Certainly becoming a force to be reckoned with on the high roller scene as well.
That's you. Uh-oh.
Me?
You're getting yelled at.
No.
Okay. You're C4, man.
They said no singing.
Everyone loved Ray.
Yeah, but they want you to do more.
All right,
Ray. They're literally telling them to.
Show your card, just swing with the camera. That's all they were asking for.
Me?
Yeah.
Give him a second.
I've been leaving the card just like that all the time.
Okay. He has been, yeah.
All right, no problem.
Oh, the whole card camera.
Is there a whole card
camera? Do I gotta use that? I don't even use it.
Oh, my cards are not lined up.
Those apparently.
I definitely haven't been using it.
Yeah.
McKeehen has one PokerGO Tour win. He won a 10K high roller at the Win in March. Ray
you
opens here at the King Queen of
Spades. They don't. I guess it's not a break yet, right? We play at this next level and then there's a break.
That is correct.
You're the man.
I was going to do it no matter what your answer was.
So. You're the man.
Damn. What if he yelled at you?
I need more chips.
I might have been a 17.
I need more chips.
Defense. The King King 4, not too bad for Ray Qartomy.
Well, we might hear a little song after this one, Jeff. Qartomy's getting his groove back.
You got more chips. Say the number.
I hope he fucking does.
Say the number.
There we go, Ray.
I won't fall for the pump anymore. I forgot yesterday.
Oh, yeah. Dude, that was brutal. Holy
shit.
Brutal.
Yeah. I didn't have a king, though, so don't worry, Ray. You got me, man.
Everybody loves Raymond.
That's what it seems like. Just seems like a blast to play with.
From him. Call blind,
I did catch that everybody loves Raymond. Liner. Thank you very much. That was good. Blind's going up to 40K, 80K.
Thank you.
With an 80K big blind ante. Seven players remain. Event number three of the U.S. Poker Open.
To Ray, first table.
All right.
All right.
There we go. Ray's back.
Ray's back.
Wait for it to fold on me and just
me
put in that many chips and just doubles right on cue. Nah, I'm still going to win. I don't think I can lose them all into Ray. Sorry, Ray, I just went.
The only person I think I'm losing all into is probably Barry.
Barry, everybody Barry.
That I would lose an all into at the stable.
Everyone
I'm okay with that.
I think I can get you 20% of the time.
Yeah, maybe.
That's if I have the 80.
I like to hear that, Barry. Everybody's scared of you.
I'm a lucky player.
Ooh.
Barry's
no, I've. But I've probably been owned by you the most out of anybody.
I was hoping start the clock and then I could just stall for like hours.
Good to know.
Almost for sure.
You know, Ali, it's very funny. The only person busts Barry all the time is Ray Qartomy.
Wow.
That's also true. He busted me in this tournament, actually.
What is your last name? Ray Qartomy? You're like a cartoon character?
No, Qartomy.
Qartomy, not cartoony.
No.
Okay.
Red. 375,000.
We can always rely on Stevie Z to bring the.
It's got the jokes.
Bring the laughs. Yeah.
Schindler, the short stack with 10 bigs. It's a decent chunk of it in with the King Jack of Diamonds. And Qartomy has the Ace 10 off in the big blind.
Yeah, close.
10 seconds.
This guy like Jake Schindler. I don't think Ace 10 is typically in all that great a shape.
Sounds serious, too.
Smile expect Schindler to have that sort of holding. King Jack suited, King Queen suited. Better aces.
He had the ace 4-0.
Medium pairs.
Falling off against me.
The game.
I started to look, that was an ace, man.
I'd kill for a big hand.
Average stack here now, less than 20 bigs.
Yeah.
Nah, I like that pot. That was
like a good
pot.
Four.
You said it, Jeff. Less than 20 bigs, the average stack. How about the chip leader? McKeehen only has 30 big blinds, 2.4 million.
Anybody's ball game.
You know it, too. That's the problem. You know you can be patient because you just know you're intimidated.
Our final seven guaranteed $38,500, about an 8K pay jump from 7 to 6. Up top in this one, more than $200,000. There's the current leader of the PokerGO Tour, Ali Imsirovic. Folds the force.
Is that what you did to other people I had to fold?
Good luck, Barry.
By other people, I mean Jake.
Sometimes I have a real hand. Could happen.
It's not good for me anyway.
Holy shit. Why'd you go so big?
Right. I don't think you can use your phone in the middle of a hand.
McKeehen is targeting.
Be careful.
Well,
Huh? Going to be raising a variety of hands from the button. Queen six off is good enough. Make it the min. He knows that Qartomy can only move all in preflop or fold, typically based on his stack size. And he's just looking to outplay Zolotow. By the time we go post-flop, there it is. Two sevens, Jeff, in the middle.
All of it. That gets through.
Is that what your phone told you? Your phone said if he raises, move all in?
Nobody can text me.
What?
30-minute delay. You cannot see the hand right
now. No, I know, but I'm just saying that's the rule. I don't. It's not my rule.
Just relax. Play your game.
Yes, sir, boss.
Have a nice, beautiful day.
So I can look up my push-fold charts and all that stuff.
You can do anything you want.
Okay.
I don't do that.
Try on that lavender.
Presented by Progressive. Those Pui chips worth $5,000 apiece, the purple $25,000, the yellow bamboulis worth $100,000 apiece.
Yeah, I jumped right in there for
you. That was good. That was good. You should have just taken it from there.
Well, I didn't want to miss it.
Yeah.
Thought you were snoozing.
I don't know if Progressive would have been comfortable with you taking a read. Most of it from Hutter with the Jack 10.
400,000.
Will we hear from Saliba for the first time? We will not.
We haven't heard anything from Saliba, not a word.
We will hear from Joe McKeehen here. It's down to two kings. Barry Hutter is in a little bit of trouble. McKeehen just calls in the cutoff.
McKeehen just hoping somebody wakes up behind. Hopefully not with aces, and here we go.
Hutter not quite all in yet. Still has 160K behind. And does flop a jack. He'll put his remaining chips in. He'll be snapped off by McKeehen. And here we go indeed. Barry Hutter, the one all in and at risk. Looking for a jack or a 10 to get there against Joe McKeehen's kings.
Ray said I was getting second, so I don't think I'm going to lose.
I don't.
Yeah, no chance.
But I mean, I had to be the one that doubled you up at least, right? I mean,
McKeehen looking to extend his chip lead. Hutter just looking to stay alive.
No, he doesn't have two diamonds.
I know. Eight diamonds.
I wasn't thinking. I prefer like the two of clubs. Took my chances with
turn card.
Yeah.
It's a seven.
Now it's probably a ten of clubs.
Hutter needs a jack or a ten to remain in this tournament. River card. It's another six. That'll do it for Barry Hutter. His second cash of the 2021 U.S. Poker Open finishes in seventh for $38,500.
Nice showing. He's going to add some points to the U.S. Poker Open leaderboard. In contention, Jeff, the Hutter butter.
Look at this, Ali. I even held on to it.
Huh?
I even held on to the one.
Yeah, you've been at one since like level three.
Yeah, I know.
I think they can square up the table.
Tell him that he has to bring over the time banks too.
Now that we're down to our final six, it's more time banks.
Bring over the time
banks. We're six.
Time banks?
Can we pause and get time banks and stuff? Do we get six more or do we go get
six more?
Six more.
We pause. Okay.
Nah, I mean, he's gonna print them out. You have extra time. We should be dealing though.
Oh, let's deal.
We should be dealing. Come on.
Okay.
As we wait for the time banks here to be redistributed to the players, Jeff, that cash for Barry Hutter takes him into now the top five. He's in fifth position with 153 points on the leaderboard. That's good for $152,000 and change.
I like that. I like this music, too.
Me too, yeah.
You just kind of feel it. You just get in the flow, get in the groove, dancing a little bit like Ray's been dancing. And there's a look at our leaderboard brought to you by Global Poker, free poker at its best. And Brent, look at the chip lead for Joe McKeehen, perhaps starting to pull away from the field.
Yeah, and these all-ins are clearly critical, right? I mean, that's 3 million chips. It looks like a pile. That's only 37 big blinds, which is about 30% of the chips in play. McKeehen's going to need to continue to pull away. Otherwise, someone's going to be nipping on his heels quite soon.
Could that someone be Ali Imsirovic, second in chips right now? Always a force to be reckoned with here.
You can tell from the backs, the good ones from the bad ones. That's pretty good.
I got the decorate.
Ace jack of clubs for Ray Qartomy. Cut off. I'll just rip it here.
Bet on 3.000.
I like that.
All right.
A little yeehaw dab.
From the Texan.
Yeah.
That's really how I draw the ladies in.
I started with 825 and then.
Counting Danny?
Yeah.
So, okay, 745.
$2 million.
Saliba and Schindler.
1.8.
The short stacks with 10 bigs.
The leader. Still the leader.
3.000.
That one.
Black number. Saliba lives here now in Las Vegas. Jeff, he's been playing a lot of the high rollers recently, really trying to find his first breakout cash. Only about $75,000 in career earnings.
Finishing seventh in an Aria High Roller in May, told us he has indeed been firing.
Great, 160.
McKeehen has opened here to 160. With the 7-5 of clubs.
Yes, sir.
360?
$360,000.
Small three bet from Ali Imsirovic with the king five suited. This is the Ali we're used to seeing.
Yeah, and he knows that McKeehen is just very handcuffed, forcing him to essentially four bet all in or fold.
That was rude.
Based on the stack size. Lovely play by the Bosnian bandit, Ali Imsirovic.
He won back-to-back events at the 2018 Poker Masters, winning a 25K for $462,000, then a 50K for about $800K. And in those two tournaments, Jake Schindler finished in fourth place. And they sit next to each other today. How about that, Brent Hanks?
And they're neighbors in real life.
See? All comes together.
The universe.
Circle of life.
So mysterious.
As long as it's not me.
A little at a time.
If you're checking us out on YouTube, we hope you're enjoying this free preview of the U.S. Poker Open. We'll shift to PokerGO exclusively at the top of the hour.
One by one.
I don't think that Ali has ever folded a suited king. Kicks it up again, 175 to go.
McKeehen with king seven off in the big blind.
Probably put in two yellows just to spite you.
Flicking it.
I don't want those fucking chips.
King 8-5, top pair for both, backdoor straight draws for both.
At the moment, temporary trouble.
80,000.
Imsirovic, McKeehen has him notched. The kicker doesn't play too often, Jeff, but it could happen.
McKeehen does check call. 630,000 now in the pot. Deuce on the turn. McKeehen checks again.
Yeah, certainly would not fault Ali for wanting to bet one more time. Various draws available. You can see two diamonds. Straight draws are present. Sure. You want to bet and deny equity, or do we play a little defense? Look at this. What a cheeky check back.
A 10 on the river, so McKeehen's kicker does play.
This is going to get snap called.
Yep.
Ali sees the sick news. None of the draws got there. Feels very good about
yes.
the king.
Got him.
How much? 380,000.
800.
380.
Gets 380,000 worth of value.
That was so fast, you scared me. Thought I might have been beat somehow.
McKeehen extends his chip lead, has almost 40% of the chips in play.
That's some bullshit.
The king six suited.
Got him.
Fuck, I wish I bet 480 now.
I was gonna bet bigger than that, so I guess that's fine.
You're supposed to tell me you would have folded if you bet bigger.
I would have check shoved. Check.
And that pot call, is man. Just so critical for a call. Obviously, we extend the chip lead
yeah.
for Joe McKeehen. He's now up to 43 big blind chef, 3.5 million. But it was yeah. against the
one
guy
five,
that was number two.
Five,
and against
four, yeah.
probably one of the most toughest opponents you're going to come across in Ali Imsirovic, who also has position on him.
You guys are even. Before the ante.
Right now, everything going Joe McKeehen's way.
McKeehen with more than double second place. Qartomy, Zolotow, and Imsirovic all around that 20 big blind mark. Stevie Z will open here. King Queen.
In the handsome?
Starbucks is over, right?
You in the handsome?
At Waldorf?
Well, you don't have to. You had zero options.
Oh, no, I was just asking.
You're too good to me.
No, my mom, anybody, I would go home while I was gone. She brought me
the lowest card in my hand was a queen. If that helps you.
Of course.
You sure? But I'm the one at Crystal Shops is open.
Steve Zolotow, the two-time World Series of Poker bracelet winner, won the 1995 5K Chinese poker event and the 2001 3K pot limit hold'em event.
Both of which, Jeff, are events they don't even run anymore at the World Series of Poker.
Because he crushed them.
No longer in service, unlike that mustache, which has been in service since the 70s, he told me.
Wow.
Same shape, design.
I mean, you speak your mind. When you say right here, no fear, I know you don't have no fear. That's the problem.
Golden Eagle Trophy, baby keeping boy. A watchful eye on the festivities.
You might have had some fear.
I pulled a big hand in the river. I did.
Pairs are hard to make. Man.
The last hand, the lowest card in my hand was a queen.
Saliba's been card dead all day.
Ugh. Painful.
Qartomy with that the ace three in the small
yeah,
blind.
Sure. You're not betting pot was painful.
Uh-huh.
How do I ever lose there?
160.
Oh, so fast.
We'll come in for the min raise out of the small blind, which you don't see often.
You don't. He's opening the door, inviting
that's what I'm saying. You
his
so
neighbor.
Fast,
perhaps Zolotow has folded to this sort of sizing along the way that we are unaware of, but
would you?
I have to imagine that most hands
think about it and either call or raise.
Are always going to play defense in position, getting such a great price. I don't think I'd fold any two, Jeff.
And you certainly wouldn't fold one of the prettiest hands in the game.
Oh.
Jack 10 of hearts.
Okay.
See, I had the respect for you, and you don't have the respect for me.
Well, I just called you. I didn't
know. No. Well, I wish
respect.
You did. I wish you did.
Really?
I promise you.
King 4-4, one heart.
You in that after this? I got no chance. I don't even know what games are in Big Bet next.
Well, it's Nolan at PLO and Deuce 7 single.
Yeah, I know how to play one of the three.
Me too.
I played less than 200 hands of the other two in my life, so I will not be in
that. I play more than that, yes, but sir. Sure.
You think
I don't
I should
think
have
ever played
with
a hand
should.
Yeah. That, like,
was trying.
Really simple game.
I don't show my card, but because I show you, I want to show you respect.
It's only single draw, so it's just super easy.
You think?
I'm not single
draw when you make a mistake. It's not like PLO where you're 60-40 when you make a mistake.
Oh, I know, but
there
like,
you're like.
Like who's the
Ray Qartomy, all entertainment. Look at this.
Unbelievable. Love this guy. Holland at the moan. Oh boy.
Feeling the rhythm of this final table is Ray Qartomy, and he's second in chips.
Oh yeah, the marble man.
Are you gonna play one today?
Well, I was, but now I'm stuck in, you know.
Steve Easy said Ray Qartomy.
After this, I'm going to want a nap, eat, you know, it's like I probably.
I'm going home.
But I mean, I was.
I'm eating a salad and passing out.
I mean, I was planning on playing.
Little extra camera time for Ray before he folds the seven.
Just
deuce.
Leave it on him, Jeff. Yeah, I mean, just keep it right on Ray the whole time.
Guarantee only, brother.
Okay.
I met it. First place only.
You want to be scared of me a little bit.
I believe.
Yeah, that can bust you.
You're great.
Be a little scared.
You're great player, you. But I would never be scared.
250.
I respect your player, you're a great player.
You gotta be scared of busting.
You gotta believe.
You gotta be scared of busting a little bit.
It's gonna be hard. I mean, you bust me, it's gonna be hard. You have to be, flop me.
Well, if you keep going all in over me, all I gotta do is have kings again. You have jacks.
If I go all in, I gotta have something better than kings.
I don't know about that.
And I think we used to, we played it pretty hard.
Yeah,
I think it was
like
25,000 or 50,000 buy-ins. Big game.
That's awesome.
And then it just died off because people don't like it.
Well, some of the people who played died. The big one, the live ones died.
We have a flop. I go
Jack 6 deuce, yeah, Jack 10 just like buried it.
This is him. This is Barry.
Like all the big games, some of the people die off.
And they hear no fear.
And the rest of us are saying, we better learn a new game.
They hear no fear.
Ali asked if the game died off, and Susie said, well, some of the players died off.
Are you allowed to have a dealer? I didn't know that.
Here's Saliba now, less than 10 bigs.
The King Deuce of Spain.
He's finally found a. No, not a qualifier. By the way, Saliba, he was a goalkeeper, University of Dayton, Dayton Flyers. He was the goalie there. It's got to be a nickname there somewhere, Jeff.
I think you could come up with that, being our resident nickname.
Depending on how bad he gets it in, I might just call him the punter.
King Jack of Hearts for Qartomy in the cutoff after McKeehen opens with the Queen 8 off.
Pin second. Call.
It's a good spot for Joe to open. If you notice where Ali is positioned in the small blind and attacking Schindler, who has a very vulnerable stack, less than 10 bigs, and Ali wakes up with the goods.
Ali with tens.
800,000.
Starting this hand with about 17 bigs. Three bet for most of his stack. McKeehen quickly out of the way.
Ray does have a very pretty hand. Just so brutal.
But yeah, behind,
just King Jack.
10 seconds.
Nice pickup for Imsirovic. Shows the tens.
Got two over early.
What the fuck was I doing in this hand?
I don't know.
I was in third. Let me beat.
Saw my hand?
No, what'd you have?
King Jack Hart. I show it.
Oh, that's
sucks. You're thrilled to get that.
Yeah, for sure.
I feel better you had it.
It's hard not to
surprised
have.
You had it, but I feel better.
Ali Imsirovic looking for his sixth PokerGO Tour win in 2021.
Yeah, I appreciate it.
Nobody else has more than two.
Here it looks like run-of-the-mill squeeze play and you really had a hand.
Told me before the final table started that he's just been running absurdly hot, but it also helps when you're one of the best. Good combination. You run well, you play well. Good things are going to happen.
Well, when he came on the scene a couple years ago, Jeff, when he won the Purple Jacket, nobody knew anything about his game. Mm-hmm. That was the first opportunity for the other high rollers to sort of see the tape, review, and understand how he was operating. He's had to adjust since that time, and boy, oh boy, he seems to have gotten better and better.
10 seconds. Call.
Qartomy calls behind with threes.
How much did you make it last time?
800.
800? It's pretty successful, that 800. I don't have my.
If you did
I
that,
don't have. I don't have your courage.
I was gonna say you are my new favorite player.
Saliba with the Jack 5 of spades in the big blind.
Getting a great price. The difficulty, though, taking a hand three-way. I guess you just
you will choose to
have
do.
To try and connect and go with it and hope it's good, right? You make any pair, any sort of draw. It's probably close.
Ace-King 10. McKeehen takes the lead here with a pair of 10s. Gut shot for both Saliba and McKeehen. Qartomy going to fire here with the threes.
Bet 125,000.
Frustrating day continues for Saliba.
I love this bet by Ray. Clearly trying to rep that sort of texture. Certainly annoyed right now by McKeehen's stickiness.
Joe not going anywhere. Another king on the turn.
Check.
Well, you would think that this card would favor McKeehen. If I were in Ray's seat, let's see if he just decides to try and represent a king. He's going to do it, Jeff. Pulling the trigger, the marble man.
Bet 225,000. And that gets the job done. Ray Qartomy with just threes gets McKeehen to fold better.
How about those marbles, huh?
The tens, Ray?
Two barrels.
Of course not.
Hard for him to have tens.